This chapter is consumer's equilibrium. Consumer equilibrium is what? Whenever a consumer is spending some money, then he is getting in return some satisfaction. Whatever satisfaction he is getting in return, then he wants to maximize it. Consumer will never pay more than the satisfaction which he is getting from the commodity. That's why it is given, it referred to a condition where a rational consumer. Rational consumer means what? The person who is thinking a lot before doing something, some action, is able to maximize his satisfaction. Now, satisfaction is what? You never can measure this satisfaction in terms of something. But some economists have tried that satisfaction can be measured in terms of utils. And later on, Marshall told that we can measure the satisfaction in terms of money also. So, to understand this chapter, consumer equilibrium, first of all, we have to understand some terms. Unless you understand these terms, it will be very difficult for you to understand the consumer equilibrium. So, first term is what? Total utility, symbolically TU. What is this? It referred to the total satisfaction received by a consumer due to the consumption of different units of a commodity. Now, suppose a consumer is consuming mango. After eating first mango, he is little bit satisfied. Then again, if he is eating second mango in continuous process, then he is getting some additional satisfaction from this. Then again, if he is consuming third mango, then he is getting some more satisfaction. Now, what actually total utility is? When we add up the individual satisfaction derived from each and every unit of mango, then we will get what? Total utility. Second term is what? Marginal utility, MU. It referred to the additional satisfaction received by a consumer due to the consumption of an additional unit of a commodity. Now, if a consumer is consuming mango, so after eating first mango, he is getting some satisfaction, then second, then third, then fourth, like this he is going on. But we are interested here to know that how much satisfaction he got from second one or how much he got from the fourth one. We are interested to know an individual item satisfaction. So additional satisfaction. To understand this better, we are having a utility schedule. The marginal utility can be derived that total utility of n commodity minus total utility of n minus 1. It will be more clear from the schedule, this table. First is what? Unit of commodity X. 1, when he is eating first mango, he is eating second mango, he is eating third mango, he is eating fourth mango, and likewise. Now, total utility derived from first mango was how much? 100. From second, 190. Third, 270. So, this is what total utility. This includes utility of first as well as of second. This includes utility of first, second and third. But we are interested to know what? Marginal utility of an individual unit of commodity. Now see, before it we were not consuming anything. Then the set's total utility was what? Nil. So when we are going to calculate marginal utility of first mango, then what we have to do? Total utility of X, 1. Then total utility of X minus 1. So 100 minus 0 is equal to 1. 100. Now second was there, we are interested to know the utility derived from the second mango, it is 90. How? That total utility from the second mango after 1 and 2 was how much? 190. And from here when we are subtracting the utility of first mango, the 190 minus 100 is equal to what? 90. Likewise, every time we have to subtract the previous utility which we derived from the consumption of different units. So likewise, we are finding 100, 90, 80, 70 and 60, so on. It is what? TUX minus TUX minus 1, 100 minus 0, 190 minus 100, like this. Okay, that's all. Next.